Chute por trás, atrás, rupam, rupam, tasakra jamuri puri, maturim, usvaritam, radha kundamadivaram, ahoralika, Pratita Kripaya Sri Guru Tam Gurave Gaura Charanaya Radhikaya Prasadaya Krishnaya Krishna Vartaya Tadvataya Namo Ananda Lila Vaya Vikraha Dema Badivyatsta Visundraya Tasmai Maha Prema Rasapradaya Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste Chaitanya Chandraya Namo Namaste First of all, I offer my sustained Dandavata Puspanjali, my heart like flowers thousands and thousands of times, at the lotus feet of my holy master, my supremely worshipable spiritual Gurudev, Asmatiya Paramaradhatama Guru Pada Padma, Nityalila Pravisht Om Nishnupad, Ashtotarasatasri, Rupanuga Acharyavarya, Sisimad Bhaktivedanta, Narayan Goswami Maharaj. Secondly, I offer my pranam thousands of times at the lotus feet of my Param Gurudev, to Srila Prabhupada, and to all of our Sri Rupanuga Gaudiya Guru Parampara. And finally, I offer my pranam to Maharaj, to our very dear Sarvabhavana Prabhu, Ananya Tutani Paragan, and all the assembled Vaishnavas and Vaishnavis, Vanchakalpatarupyascha, Kripasindubhyevacha, Patitanam Bhavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. By the causeless mercy of Sri Guru and Gauranga, today we have been honoring this most auspicious occasion of Sri Guru Purnima, which is the Avirbhav Tithi, the appearance day of the great Sri Krishna Dwaipayan Veda Vyas. So this morning we heard so many pastimes regarding the life history of Srila Vyasadev, and especially how Srila Vyasadev was feeling dissatisfied even after he had compiled, he had divided the one Veda into four, and he had presented the Upanishads, Vedanta Sutra, the Puranas, the Mahabharata, and even within that Bhagavad Gita, But still he was feeling dissatisfied. And at that time, his Guru Pada Padma, Sri Narada Rishi, who is traveling all over the universe, riding upon the curse of Daksha Maharaj, to fulfill his vow to deliver all living entities. That very Narada Rishi arrived there at Samyaprash Ashram. And he chastised Srila Vyasadeva for writing so many things about karma, jnana, yoga, and mukti in personal liberation. Why have you not delineated Bhavata Anudinam Prayam Yasho Bhagavato Malam Yeneva Aso Natusyaita Manyaita Darshanam Kilam? Srila Narada Muni said, your vision, your darshan, your philosophy is very limited because you have not satisfied the Supreme Lord by that. The purpose of everything, some Siddhira Ritoshanam, is to please Krishna. But you have not done it. Why? Bhavata Anudita Prayam Yasho Bhagavato Malam. Because you have not described the immaculate, spotless Prem Lila of Brajendra Nandan Shama Sundar Sri Krishna in Vrindavan. So after receiving so many teachings from Narad, he was instructed to go into trance. And Srila Vyasadeva entered into the trance of Bhakti Yoga. Bhakti Yogena Manasi Samyak Pranhite Male Apasyat Purusha Purnam Mayam Chachada Pasrayam. And he saw all the pastimes of Krishna in the spiritual world, and all the manifestations of Maya, the Srishti Lila, the material world. And he saw that the jivas were floating in Maya, and how they could be delivered, they could be transferred from the material world to the spiritual world simply by hearing this message of Srimad Bhagavatam, Yasyam Vaishulumanayam Krishne Paramapuruṣe Bhakti Utpatite Pungsa Shoka Moha Vayapaha. Simply by giving submissive oral reception to the message of Srimad Bhagavatam, the feeling of love for Krishna, bhakti, awakens in the heart and removes all fear, illusion, and lamentation. So this we discussed in some detail this morning. So I just want to speak briefly now, because I'm very eager to hear from our great Vaishnavas who are present. So this pastime has many important teachings for all of us. The first one is that Srila Vyasadeva, he was dissatisfied. He was thinking, what is the fault in me? But he could not discover the answer to that. So the meaning is that in our life, we cannot see our own faults. We are blind to our own faults. And therefore, Sri Guru is necessary. Who can see what is our shortcoming? What is lacking in us? Srila Vyasadeva says, Snatasya nunam ne alam vichakshva. Please just tell me, what is lacking in me? He asked this question to Narada. So this is the first thing. Then the second thing, who requires the guidance and inspiration of Sri Guru? Everyone. Even Vyasadeva himself, who has compiled all the Vedas, the Puranas, Vedanta, Bhagavad Gita, he himself requires inspiration and guidance. So what to speak of any ordinary living entity in Kali Yuga? Are you more advanced than Vyasadeva? No. I am also not more advanced than Vyasadeva. So I am always seeking shelter and guidance from the senior Vaishnavas. It is essential in our life. So Vyasadeva has shown us this. This is the second teaching. Third teaching. Srila Vyasadeva had explained so much tattva jnana, but he was not satisfied. This shows to us that only hearing, studying, and remembering tattvas, jiva tattva, maya tattva, Vedanta sutra and everything. Your heart will not become satisfied. Only when one lila katha nisevanaya, when a person engages in serving the very beautiful lila katha, then his heart will become satisfied. So at first, Vyasadeva was not satisfied with hearing all and writing about all the tattvas, but later, when he realized the sweetness of Krishna Leela, then he became satisfied. So don't neglect to hear the beautiful pastimes of Sri Krishna. Then, fourth teaching. Srila Vyasadeva went into Bhakti Samadhi, very deep. And there he realized the name, form, qualities, associates and Leela of Sri Krishna. So, it should be understood that we cannot realize Sri Krishna's pastimes in our ordinary state of consciousness. When the mind is vikshipta, distracted by one thing and another thing all the time, one thing after another. No. When we're chanting the holy names, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. Kirtana prabhave smarna hive. By the power of the holy name, the mind becomes peaceful and then one is able to remember. Remember Krishna, Naam, Rup, Gun and Lila. So one should go, the stages of smaran are there. The first stage is just called smaran. And then as the mind becomes more steady, more focused, then there is a dharana, concentration. And then the mind becomes even more steady and absorbed and completely detached from everything, all the external sense objects. One doesn't know who am I, where am I. He goes in a state of dhyan. So there is naam smaran, rup dharan, concentration on the form of Krishna. Then gun dhyan. In the state of dhyan, one can realize Krishna's qualities and associates. And then dhruvanu smriti. When the dhyan meditation continues for a long time, it turns into dhruvanu smriti, continuous remembrance. And there is then realization of Krishna Leela. And only when the dhruva anusmriti becomes even deeper and becomes samadhi, then in your beautiful spiritual form, you also not only realize but enter into that lila in the state of samadhi. So, when we're chanting Hare Krishna, we should have some direction, some ambition. Where are we going here? Not just chanting and doing Brahmananda Parakrama, wandering all over the universe in the mind. But rather, naam, rup, tannam, rupa, charitari, sukirtananu, smrityo, krameena, rasanam, anasini, yoja. Engage the tongue and the mind sequentially in remembering all these things. So, Vyasadeva, he went into trance and realized the beautiful pastimes of Krishna. Now, perhaps you know that there was a prince named Gautama. And once he was kept inside the palace and he never saw any suffering. But one day with his teacher he went outside and he saw a person with a wrinkled face who could not walk. He said, "What's this?" His teacher said, "This is old age." "Old age? What's that?" "Oh, this happens to everyone." He was amazed. Then he saw a procession going down, many people singing, "Ram Nam Satyahe Ram Nam." He said, "What's that?" His teacher said, "That is death." "Death? What is that?" "Oh, you become old, then you die." He saw some diseased person. So in this way, his eyes were open to the suffering of life. He said, "What am I doing here?" And he renounced his position as a prince. And he went to the forest to find the meaning of life. So that Gautama, later became known as Buddha, he sat down and tried to deeply meditate to discover the goal of life. And gradually, he went into samadhi. He went into trance. And in his samadhi, he saw shunya. Everything was empty. And declared to the life, to the people of the world, the meaning of life, according to Buddha, is Shunya. Everything is meaningless. Everything is empty. You have to realize this truth. So, now compare these two personalities. Srila Vyasadeva sat down, he went into Samadhi and he saw all the pastimes of Krishna. Buddha sat down, he went into Samadhi and saw nothing. Why? Because Buddha did not have a Sadguru. But Srila Vyasadeva was ordered to remember his mantra and how to meditate by his Sadguru. Nitya Siddha Mukta Mahapurush Narada Rishi. And because Narada Rishi had Anubhuti, realization, Anubhav, then at the time, the sadhan kal, at the time of practicing, then Srila Vyasadeva, in his heart, all the realizations of his Guru Padma appeared there in the form of Krishna Lila. So here the teaching is that unless you have Sadguru, bona fide Guru, who has realization of Sri Krishna, you will, if you don't have this, then you will realize a very round number. Zero. Nothing. So it is essential to be in the shelter of Sadguru. Teaching number five. Then one more teaching. Number five. One more for today. If you will glorify Sri Krishna, then Krishna, he may be somewhat pleased, but not fully pleased. Why? Because Krishna said, Mad Bhakta Puja Vyadika, better is the worship of my devotee. And of all the personalities who have devotion, who have praying, the highest praying is there in Mahabhav Swarupini. Vladimira Sara Prem, Prema Sara Bhav, Bhava Paramakasta, Nama Mahabhav, Mahabhava Swarup Sri, Radha Takurani, Sarvaguna Kani, Krishna Kanta Shiramani. The essence of Ladini Shakti is Prem, the essence of Prem is Bhav, the essence of Bhav is Mahabhav, and the embodiment, the Swarup of all Mahabhav, is Simati Radhika. So if a person will glorify Vrishabhanu Nandini, Astasaki Shiramani Paramakaruna Mai Chandravali Vijayini, who can defeat Sati, Lakshmi, Satya, Rati, Chandravali, everyone, who has more love than anyone, if someone will glorify that Srimati Radhika, then Krishna becomes pleased. So because Srila Vyasadeva has manifested in Srimad Bhagavatam, the Rasalila, Anaya Radhito Nunam Bhagavan Hari Ishvara Yamno Vihaya Govinda Prito Yammanayadraha. How in the Rasalila, see Krishna disappeared, leaving all Brajagopis, only he went away with Srimati Radhika. And then the gopis saw Krishna's footprints and saw Radhika's footprints next to Krishna and said, oh, this gopi must have worshipped Bhagavan Hari Ishwara more than anyone else, because her desire to be with the coward boy Govinda has been fulfilled. Govinda has taken her away with himself alone, leaving all of us. So in Srimad Bhagavatam, this verse is like the beating of kettle drums, announcing the supremacy of Srimati Radhika throughout the entire universe. Jai Jai Sri Radhe! So Yasmin to stay, Jagat to stam. When Krishna is pleased, the whole universe becomes satisfied. So because Srila Vyasadeva, in his final contribution, Srimad Bhagavatam, he has presented the supreme glories of Srimati Radhika, therefore Krishna was satisfied, and when Krishna was satisfied, then finally Srila Vyasadeva became fully satisfied. So this is the message of Srimad Bhagavatam. Try to make the goal of your life, Radha Dasyam, to become the maid servant of Srimati Radhika. Gaur Premanande.